the Singapore Turf Club's come a long way in a very short time.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Yes, it is. I mean, but racing has been in Singapore for more than 170 years. I mean, it's been a long time. It's only in the past 10, 15 years or so since we moved to Kranji with this new facility, we managed to lift racing here up another notch to where we are now.
Singapore Turf Club and you and your committee have invested a lot of money and been very proactive in providing fantastic facilities, both on the track here and in the training complex.
Yes, I mean, one of the thing that we face here in Singapore is a restriction of land. I mean, we are not a very big country like, say, in Australia, where you have land everywhere, you can train horses practically on a farm. So what we set out here to do is that within this small area, we try to provide as much facilities as possible in terms of tracks, in terms of stables, in terms of the, facilities for owners, for trainers and so on, to make the whole place a complete training centre.
One of your recent additions has been the hill track, but yes, you're also in the process of building a very impressive new swimming pool complex.
Yes, yes. The hill track, well, first on the hill track, I mean, that one has been a tremendous success. I mean, we have been wanting to do a hill track for the past, ever since we moved here, but we just couldn't find the resources to do it, but we managed to do it recently, and it has been great success. I mean, for matter of fact, Rocketman trains exclusively on the hill track. And where the swimming pool is concerned, we have one, and again, the population of horses here have grown so big that, you know, with one pool, we just can't accommodate the needs anymore. So therefore, the second one, which is coming up in a couple of months' time.
You've also been very successful in attracting some great trainers from around the world and jockeys.
Mm-hmm.
Is that something you work hard at?
Yes, because Singapore is not a very big country. Again, I mean, we have a small population base, and therefore we need a lot of talent from overseas to come here and to grow the industry. This is where, when we started out here, we actually went out and looked for some of the better trainers to come over here to train. People like Patrick Shaw, Michael Friedman, and to name Laurie, to name a few. And as well as jockeys, so that these are big names in our own countries. So they lend their name to the industry and help us grow.
It's obviously a great credit to you guys when you, everyone in the world's chasing someone like Joe Marrera, he decides he wants to stay here in Singapore.
Well, Joe is special. I mean, he is now acclimatized himself so well here in Singapore, he's practically almost a Singaporean. But there will come a day where Joe will go home. Hopefully not in the near future. He always say that, no, my heart is still in Brazil. But you know, hopefully that day will be a few more years down the road.
Things are pretty tight around the world economically at the moment. A lot of race clubs are dropping their prize money, but the prize money here has always been extremely solid, and you've got a great setup there.
Yeah. Well, one of the pillars of our so-called development for the past few years is the returns to owners, in terms of their investment in the horses and so on. One of the key things that we look at is we need to make it attractive for people to own horses here. And therefore, the prize money level has been set at the level where it makes sense to own a horse in Singapore. Like in many other countries, like for example, even in England, the prize money levels are not that high. And you find that, you know, a lot of the owners are giving up. But here, we if you don't have good prize money and good returns to the owners, no owners will own horses. Yeah.
I think it's $65,000 for a restricted maiden.
Mm-hmm.
But you've also got a very unique rebate system. Tell us a little bit about that. Yeah.
Well, what we do here is that, because if you look at the traditional way of racing, it's a distribution of prize money, right? You either pay up to the first four or first five, which is well and good, but it only benefit a few horses. So what we do is that we actually cream a bit of the prize money and spread it down to the rest of the horses, so that at least, even if the owner do not finish in the first three or first four or first five, they will still get something back to help cover for the cost of keeping the horse in Singapore. I mean, that had worked. And obviously, the incentives also goes not only to the trainer, not only to the owner, but to the trainer as well. That also encouraging the trainer with their cost, because they do have high overheads here, and that helps everyone.
You've always been very embracing to international owners. There's no limitation here. You don't have to have a permit. You can have as many horses as you like.
Yes, yes. There's this is again is something very Singaporean. We open our doors and anyone who want to own a horse here, you can. All you need to do is just fill out the form. We take a look at it, and there are very basic requirements. You must be an adult, obviously, and you must be not a bankrupt, and that's about it.
You race here most Friday nights and Sundays, and the facilities here for the actual the viewer and the spectator, first class.
Thank you, thank you. Because this, again, you know, we this Kranji has been built about, we are into our 13th or 14th year now. We are constantly improving. And in fact, if you look around you, we are still improving some of the, we are now part of the grandstand on the level one for the public areas being refurbished at this, as we speak. And we believe that we need to continue to upgrade the facilities to continue to attract the customers here.
What does the future hold now for Singapore Turf Club? Where do you see yourself in the next 5 to 10 years?
Well, at this point in time, I mean, we everyone knows we have been a bit affected by the two casinos down the road. Turnover has been declining a bit for the past 1 or 2 years. But like in many other countries, when casinos started, at first there's an initial effect, but over time, turnover actually start to pick up again. We are starting to see the turnover improving a bit, and hopefully, you know, that will continue. And moving forward, well, I think racing still have a place to play in Singapore because there is a niche market, and we can see more and more people actually now starting to come back to the industry, and I think it will continue to grow.
I think the world's got Singapore up on a pedestal now as one of the international racing nations, and I think there's a lot more to look forward to.
Yeah, thank you. Hopefully we can keep ourselves there.